One of the biggest fake news of COVID-19 India was one of the leading popular channels of India, Zee News. They gave a breaking news saying the main person responsible for spreading COVID-19 in India is Dr. Zakir Naik. He picked up Malaysian Tabligh Jamaati, Malaysian Muslim from Tabligh Jamaat, and he put COVID-19 in them and told them to go to India.
Zakir Naik ke ishare par taiyar hue corona bomb.
SubhanAllah.
A logical person in his wildest dream, and by Zee News, which is one of the leading news channels in India.
Malaysia jamaatiyon ki bhoomika is corona aatmghati hamle mein ahem hone ki wajah se Zakir Naik jo Malaysia mein reh raha hai uska bhi is saazish mein shamil hone se inkaar nahi kiya ja sakta.
That's a gen, yeah.
As a whole, the Hindus in India and the non-Muslims in India, they aren't against Muslims as a whole. But later on, because of the political situation, they felt that we can use religion as a trump card to come to power. BJP RSS, they started using that. And they started propagating animosity against the Muslims to come to power. And with that, maybe the percentage of the Hindus against Muslims may have increased to 10%. But because of the fear psychosis, the people supporting Muslims has reduced to 5%. And the neutral is 85%. As time is going on, because of the threat they're giving on the social media and the open lynching of the Muslims and giving a clear-cut picture to the Hindus that if you support Muslims, we will attack you. So they have been attacking those Hindus who are supporting Muslims. Because of that, the people openly supporting Muslim has reduced. So now I would feel that after they've come to power the second time, the people against Muslims may be approximately 15%, 5% in favor, and yet 80% neutral. But these 80% neutral, they're afraid of showing that they're neutral because they're afraid of the government. They are saying the major cause of COVID-19 to enter into India are the Muslims. And there are many examples. They are blaming and they are saying that gathering that happened in Delhi, 4,000 people of the Tabligh Jamaat, you know, it's one of the largest Sunni Muslim gathering that takes place throughout the world without any publicity, without any media. They gather in large numbers in different parts of the world. So according to the fact, when they had that gathering, they had all the police permissions. So that gathering wasn't illegal at all. So it is wrong to blame them because if they did not take permission, then you can hold them responsible. So Tabligh Jamaat, when they had that gathering in mind, they did not break any law. But what happened when the gathering of few days got over, immediately, without any notice, the government announced that there's going to be a lockdown next day. So the people who had gathered from different parts of the country and outside India, they tried to go back home to the city. They could not. So many of them came back to the Markaz, and when they came back to the Markaz, the government said, now you're breaking the law, that during lockdown, how can few hundred people or 1,000 people gather there, which is totally wrong. I mean, they did not do it willingly. It was without any warning. Furthermore, what the news is saying, that majority of the cases of the Tabligh Jamaat is from COVID-19. The fact is that there are other news available that majority of the people, there was hardly anyone who was tested positive. So the news, the whole news media of India, the mainstream media, except for one channel, NDTV, the majority of the mainstream media has been purchased by the government. Either it's owned by the BJP government, or they are friends of BJP government, or they're bought over by BJP government. You see, it's very disheartening that, you know, Muslims are, there are many hospitals in India owned by Hindus. They said Muslim cannot be treated in hospital.
Yes, I saw that. Yeah.
Subhanallah. Then there are cases where, like in Delhi and some cities in India, that Muslims aren't allowed to sell their stuff in the market.
The video of Suresh Tiwari, who is a BJP MLA from Uttar Pradesh, asking people in Deoria district not to purchase vegetables from Muslim vendors has now gone viral. And when the MLA was asked about it, he said he has done nothing wrong. And now, another UP BJP MLA has been filmed on this video threatening a Muslim vegetable vendor again.
And when there were some Muslim vendors who sold their vegetables, these hooligans, they came and they forced the people who bought the vegetables to give it back. And they hunted these Muslims out. So there are so many things. There's open lynching. There's open... They fail to realize that, do you know, that the company, the medical pharmaceutical company, which has been deputed by the Indian government for COVID-19, is owned by a Muslim. Sipla.
SubhanAllah.
The person who gave one of the largest donations to India to fight COVID-19, Azim Bhai Premji, Muslim.